The first thing I'm going to do is change my workspace to editing, which will show me windows and features more suited to what we are going to do next. Go to Window, Workspaces, Editing. To import clips into the new sequence, select them in the project window and drag them into the timeline window. Once you drop clips into the timeline, a preview appears in the program window. This window shows you what is in the timeline, what will eventually become your exported video. If I double-click on a clip in the project window, it will appear in the source window. This is the raw clip, which I'll always have as a source. In the program and source windows, you can control the playback functions on the toolbar at the bottom of each window. By dragging or scrubbing the blue playheads, you can jump to or find a section of a clip or sequence. In both windows, you can control the zoom view by selecting a percent or fit, which is fit to frame. This is not the scale of your clip, just the size of the frame you are previewing in the window. I like to see the edges of the frame, so I'm going to zoom out a bit so I can see the edge. In the timeline, you can zoom in and out of the view by clicking, holding, and dragging on the dot at the end of the bar at the bottom of the timeline. Click and drag out to the side to zoom out. Drag in to zoom in. In the timeline, the video is on top, the track starting with V. The audio is on the bottom, the track starting with A. The location of the blue playhead in the timeline will be reflected in the program window. I can scrub this blue playhead to show you. Let's take a look at the important tools in the program window. The play button will play your timeline footage forward. The stop button will stop it. For a keyboard shortcut, the spacebar plays and stops the playhead. The open bracket will create an endpoint. The close bracket will create an outpoint. I and O are keyboard shortcuts for this. You can see the in and out points with the blue highlight in the timeline. To jump to an in or out point, use the bracket arrow buttons. To jump to a point in the timeline, you can input a number directly into the program window. This could also be done in the timeline. Once you make any significant change to your project, or every few minutes, save it. Go to File, Save, or hold down Command and S.